In this guide, we are going to discuss reasons of masonry cracks and importance of providing joints at critical locations. Masonry movement joints are one of the most misunderstood and unappreciated technical issues in the masonry industry. Joints are used in brickwork to accommodate such movements and to avoid cracking. Masonry move because of temperature causes bricks to expand and contract, moisture movement, structural loading. Movement of masonry. Unreinforced wall expand by about 1 mm per meter during life of structure. What are control joints? Control joints are typically used in to reduce the occurrence of shrinkage-related cracking. They also help control cracks from movements other than shrinkage. It is continuous vertical joints that permit a masonry wall to move little under pressure without cracking. Expansion joints. Expansion joints are placed in masonry walls to allow room for the wall to expand. Expansion joints will get smaller as masonry products expand, closing the gap. For that reason, mortar should never be allowed in brick expansion joints. Control joints. When control joints are required, masonry only requires vertical control joints. Walls with adequate horizontal reinforcement may not require control joints. Required wear shrinkage cracking may spoil the appearance of the wall and to limit moisture penetration. Control joint locations. Cracking due to volume changes in the masonry due to drying shrinkage or temperature changes are likely to create tension in the masonry that will exceed its tensile capacity. Common locations are: first, at changes in wall height; second, at changes in wall thickness, such as at duct chases and pilasters; third, at two or more walls interact; fourth, at above and below movement joints in roofs and floors that bear on a wall; fifth, near one or both sides of door and window openings; sixth, height changes of internal wall. Use of reinforcement. Use of reinforcement provide at above listed locations. It provides some type of controls over cracks. Expansion joint details. Leave a gap of 20 mm in long lengths, such as in compound walls. This allows independent movements of wall sections. The spacing of such joints depends upon local temperature and seismic conditions. Common spacing are: first, for brick wall with brick foundation, 5 to 7 meters; second, for brick wall with brick foundation and reinforcement, 7 to 10 meters; third, for brick wall with RCC footing and ground beam, 30 meters. Crack in multi-story buildings. There is differential movement between RCC and masonry. Provide horizontal expansion joints every two story to allow for such movement. Joint filling material. Material should be compressible by at least 50%. Use baker rods, foam pads, or neoprene pads. In vertical joints, cover such rods with polyurethane joint sealants. Summary. It is important that the designer fully considers the movement of brickwork considering the geometry of the building and its orientation. The frequency, location and the width of the joints should be sufficient to accommodate both reversible and irreversible movements.